Yes, let's fight more reapers without being able to heal. This is how we'll lose people, and it's bullshit. Because I took a wound there when basically I couldn't do anything. Alright, anyway, it is what it is. Seven skill points. Okay. This music, though. God damn. Oh, we have everyone now. Seriously. This guy's a beast. I'm leveling up everybody just in case it actually matters. Damn, that's not bad at all. Oh my god. That all? Alright, now who the fuck will I use? Oh, I'm using grit. Oh, it put it automatically, alright. I will remove you and put Lofeng. And I want you to... I might remove Flint or Soap. Yeah. Just in case it actually works. Plus one attack, minus four health. Can you? Yeah, you can now. Okay. Then I remove you. I didn't remove you. Should I take a healer? Or take here because it breaks armor, that's pretty fucking good. Can't take energy basically, okay. Attack plus one for archers. That might be better than the bear. Why did you keep the bear? There we go. Alright, let's see if this works. Let's check my deck to just in case I actually have anything else I should use. That's not bad. Again, this could be really good, but I have no idea how you would use it. That's not bad. So many spells. Okay, this will do. Hopefully. I wish I could pick up Hopper too. Oh, come on. I thought it was all around. but it isn't. It's fine. We'll kill them like that. Sure, why not? That doesn't turn. Let's not do that. So probably focus on this guy instead of the small ones, because then this guy will play you constantly, which is a bad idea. Go for it. That's fine. Should have come closer. Good. Thank you for that. I appreciate it. Doing that. Crap. That's fine. Yes, not very smart, thankfully. Yeah, don't have any non-normal weapons. Oh, it's that guy. The one that possesses buddies. Huh. Master Tildao, the archeress, has deceived us all. You will find the last words on the dearest one, or in the very end. Take into yourself, that's what you can take, for there is no one else to take it. And if you do not burn out, carry it. With every step, your burden shall become heavier, for you carry it for many, and their number increases still. You will save yourself by saving others, but you will not keep misfortune away because you carry misfortune with you, or within you. God of mine, the fire, the wind, the water, the air, and the earth, and the salt of the earth. Accept my flesh, my spirit, and my love. Seven, protect us. Your hand returns to its normal color and you feel a surge of strength, but you cannot move a finger. It's like time has stopped. The one bearing the mark grows much taller. Oh, great. Her eyes became pitch black, yet her voice didn't change. Did we get saved? Why do you have black eyes? I think it was a sea, well, no matter. We didn't open the gate and managed to keep her out. Still, she's just on the other side, and she isn't going anywhere. She's inside you, trapped, for now at least. The plight has been forestalled. The corrupted sacred stones remain lifeless. This song is amazing. But the ripping grips loosens until it finally disappears without a trace. Finally, it's time to put out the fires. Contemplate the horrible things you have experienced. Mourn the dead and forget the aftertaste of madness and blood on your lips. Scuffed by an unknown witch curse, the scribe Hopperuli, also an Umbra and Kuro called Blance, completed the journey laid out for him. He read a spell which made him realize that all of the Ripping's power, all the sorcery that devoured human lives and pulled him into the abyss, was accumulated for one purpose only. To confine an almighty mad god to a human body. This one spell, assembled from fragments, was like a tiny pebble that brought down the rock slide and prevented the end of this world. Seeing the tired, scarred, empowered, yet still human eyes staring at him brought Blanche happiness and enormous relief. Nothing was over yet, but at least he had time to breathe.
Chilla arrived at Hungry Step the same day dark clouds loomed over Opakum. She was gazing gloomily over the boundless valley when the menhir was destroyed, and its remains beheld the dreadful ritual. She grimaced, but not because of the deadly desert that awaited. Though the events in Opacum unfolded 1,000 leagues from her, Chilla felt every moment.
So Chilla was not Philia then. Philia was really her daughter.
Everything she concocted in Albius's town hall has ended just as it should have. Did she know that by going against her deity's will, she'd be able to seal it away in someone's flesh and blood? She couldn't answer. The only thing certain is that the horror befalling Terminum has only been stalled. The important thing is, Blance carried out the mission she gave him. He also seems to have realized that her sorcery was not a curse. Same as how 700 years ago,
damn,
her arrows that kept Blance from getting excarnated in the drowsy deep were not a curse. If this is a sacrifice, hasn't she carried its heaviest burden? And what's next? There is still far to go. It wasn't like Chilla to give up. She thought not of her daughter, nor even her own plan. A delicate lacework of steel. Nor did she wonder how it would all end. Her ending was nowhere in sight. She thought about her coming journey, and even about her whole life. Being a one-way trip, and about pain and death, burdening more than just Terminum's dwellers. The ones sealed away in the center of that corrupted land have it much worse. That's where she's going. She must make it.
What was that? Parsimonious hero save the prince. The lack of Dunkards, the lack of wise guys, save the king. Finish the game without losing a single battle. These are the achievements that you don't see, by the way. That ending was something else. Let's wait until the end of the credits. I want to see if there are any more cutscenes. The combat was kinda easy, at least on Ripping 4. But I think that was the good ending, although I have no idea because what the fuck happened. Alright, until you get somewhere, let me summarize some thoughts. Fantastic animation. Pretty great art on portraits, on characters, on combat, on everything, basically. Probably the best soundtrack of this year so far. Whoever did that, you did an amazing job. Really. Fantastic work. The gameplay was interesting, the combats were satisfying. I probably should have played it on a bit harder, although I didn't mess it up, I just went with how the story went. So I'm not sure there. If this is supposed to be the level you should place, I think a bit harder would be more challenging combat wise. I really like the different abilities everybody had. Lo Feng and the Hopper in particular were massive beasts. And they did a great job differentiating everybody's character combat wise, unlike the Banner Saga 1. They had a lot more abilities, everybody had different abilities. So good stuff there. The writing is the only weak point of the game, and not so. Oh, let's wait. No, doesn't have anything else. Damn it. And not just on the main storyline, which wasn't bad. It was kinda what the fuck happened, so I need to go actually read on a forum because that ending was weird after the our characters. But the dialogue itself had issues. The pacing was off. And again, it felt like I'm reading a translation from another language that was not translated as best as they could have done. It was off somehow. But still, pretty good game. Very satisfying. It took me 20 hours to finish this. So that's a pretty good length of time. Perhaps even an optimal length of time for me. Didn't outstay its welcome, and it wasn't too short. And it's only 22-23 euros to buy. So pretty goddamn cheap for the experience. I would definitely recommend this game. Which is weird because I played Banner Saga 1 and I liked it, but I didn't like it that much. I found a lot of the things that happened arbitrary, especially on your characters. Like you could make a choice that could kill a character, and it was not obvious at all. It was very random. I didn't feel this in this game. The only part I felt I messed up was saving the sun, and that was because I didn't rush there, which I should have realized, I guess, and done so. Too bad. Other than that, I'm pretty satisfied with my playthrough. So I'll end this here. Thanks for watching. If you watch on YouTube, thanks for watching this whole series. I will be back tomorrow with some Kingdom Come Deliverance, and I'll probably play that until Tuesday. Yeah, Tuesday. Where BattleTech or when BattleTech releases. And I'm going to be jumping into that day one, since I already have it pre-ordered, because that looked awesome, and Herbane Studios are also awesome and made some pretty good games in the Shadowrun series. I might stream a bit later too. I might just stop, make a coffee and play some Kingdom Come, I don't know. But for now I'll end the stream here, and I'll decide later. Have a good day, and I'll see you next time, or if you go on YouTube, in another series.